Hello, my name is StumpUp, and today we're gonna play Google Snake. Is also another game that needs somewhat much of a concentration. So I will not concentrate that much in this video either. Let's get this up. There is also not lot to talk about this game, except that the game concept is incredibly old. It's like maybe one of the first games. Also, it has had incredibly long time of people playing it. And now it is in the internet for free. Let's actually change one thing. To this. I like the sound that it makes always when I turn. And the fact that you can like change the snake's color and that kind of stuff is also fun. I remember one time when me and my friends went to this place where you can inspect the code of any chosen program, and we changed some of the code, like nearly every texture in the game into game logo that I have no idea what game it was, but the logo said a snake attack. Yeah, we actually did that. That wasn't a joke. Don't ask why we did that. If there ever really was a reason, I do not remember it. One incredibly annoying thing is that this is controlled by the arrow keys and not WASD. Ooh, 26. I wonder what's the limit Since maybe there is not code limit for the amount of gathered things or apples in this case, but at some point you just become too long. So that immediately when you get the next apple, you will touch your tail and automatically die. There's also game modes you can play. Oh, and themes. Different when we did the snake attack. Let's pick this. Let's see what it does. Oh, all the fruit apples fly. It would be fun if there would be game where you play as the apple, and it would of course be this game mode where the apples move. And you would have to like escape the apple. Let's also let's pick strawberries. And what's this? Oh, you can have larger arena. Or I guess that other one is tinier arena. And then there's the normal size. And there is also the mode where you can't die. Now I have noticed that these strawberries have just like they spawn and they move to one direction and then they hit a wall and go to another direction. Instead of choosing where they want to go. Also, they bounce off you if you don't go directly at them with your head pointing to them. This seems fun. Maybe we put the How didn't I die to my own tail there, but We can. Does that make me slower? And I'm guessing this one makes me the super snake, super fast snake. This is actually kind of harder than normal. Okay, let's maybe go. No, this one I want to do. That. And yeah. Did I pick the normal size? I did. Let's go back to the normal background. Being fast is incredibly hard. And now every time when I eat, it spawns, or almost every time I eat, it spawns walls. Every E. No, this is odd number. What if? I'm going fast in incredibly small area with walls spawning. Thank you. Why does it cycle between different colors? And we're also hunting peanuts. Oh, this is confusing. But that sound effect, though, is hilarious. But it kind of makes this easier. Let's just now, this is a fun. And I don't have to like worry about being right next to a wall when I eat something. Except if it's my tail. But let's show a fun mode. If we scroll this into here, you can't die. As you can see there, even you aren't the thing that can kill you. And the only way to lose this is by pressing. Then there's the mixer. That... okay. So, one thing we can notice that this is possible to die in here. Since there is no end mark. Also, the map isn't infinite. And now it's a different. Okay, so we have holes. It's the key thing. And the map doesn't have walls and it just cycles through. Ooh, those can kill you. Well, that was also with fast mode. Oh, no, the fast mode is something. What? Yeah, I knew that those were bad, those gray ones. I accidentally got it. But they're also kinda funny to use. Okay. What's that tail thing? Oh yeah, I can also let the shadow version. Eat the things. Shadow puzzle thing. So I always teleport to the other fruit. But with this map, it's incredibly complicated to tell where you're gonna teleport. Okay, walls, teleportation. I have holes and flying thing. What? I thought going in those was a good thing. Thank you. Why do I die when I go there? Oh, that would have been fun. They could make it so that you can choose them, like multiple of those yourself. So, whenever I eat, I become partly ghost. Does apply to those bad foods. The thing is, you really don't know what comes, or like what all the twists before you eat. Okay. Oh, I just realized that I could basically do the inspection code thing and copy paste multiple things in multiple twists into the same thing. But I'm not sure how that works, so I'm not gonna do that. And let's just. Okay. That was kind of fun. Oh, it's this kind of thing. But maybe this does something after I eat. Oh, I teleport to the other. Oh, so I can't touch the square that the flag is in. I want to see if What's this? And what the heck is that thing over there? They crumble apart. But the flag thing was also here. This is actually kind of fun twist. So basically, I need to go through that without turning. Oh, I can turn, I guess. Let's try not to destroy the flags. Let's put the fast mode off. It's so hard to realize that the flags kill you. Oh, those two overlap. Three overlap. Oh, I became my worst enemy. How long is this video? I think that's it for the episode. I hope you liked it. I'll see you in the next one.